As of today, the 29th of September 2024, Earth has a second moon hanging out with us for the next 57 days. It's not exactly a additional moon in the traditional sense. It's more like a tiny cosmic visitor, an asteroid that's temporarily trapped in Earth's gravity, dubbed a mini moon. But what makes a space object like an asteroid a mini moon in the first place? First of all, the term mini moon is not something invented by the media, which people on Reddit seem to think. It was actually a term initially coined by scientists. The first instance I could find was from this paper in 2014, and it has been used as a term in several papers since. Now, an asteroid can be considered a mini moon if it gets temporarily caught by Earth's gravity, but unlike our permanent moon, these mini moons don't stick around for long. Their orbits are unstable, and they don't complete full loops around the Earth like the moon does before they get yanked back out by the sun's gravity. Now, how long does a mini moon stick around? It can range anywhere from a few hours to a few months. For example, the upcoming mini moon, 2024 PT5, will be with us from today, the 29th of September, to the 25th of November this year. So what makes a mini moon mini? Almost unsurprisingly, it's their size. These objects are much smaller than our moon, typically just a few meters to even just tens of meters in diameter. Now, for the real space nerds watching, you may be wondering about quasi-satellites of Earth and what makes a mini moon distinctly different from them. While those guys also hang around Earth's orbit, they're more like distant neighbors that are influenced more by the sun's gravity rather than the Earth's. Mini moons are temporarily captured by Earth's gravity, so they're more strongly influenced by the Earth than the sun during their mini moon period. What's cool is that mini moons tend to originate from places like the Arjuna asteroid belt, which I didn't know about until I started looking into this mini moon business. The Arjuna asteroids share a similar orbit to Earth, so they're the most likely group of asteroids to become mini moons. And so far, including this latest one, we've had 5 confirmed mini moons. Now that we know what they are, how do we even spot something as small and fleeting as a mini moon? Well, that's where our space surveillance superheroes come in. On August 7th, 2024, the Astro-Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System, or ATLAS for short, detected this mini moon. ATLAS is designed to keep an eye out for space rocks that could pose a threat to Earth, but this time, it picked up a visitor from the Arjuna asteroid belt. Now, 2024 PT5 is a bit of a cosmic heavyweight compared to some other mini moons we've had. It's about 10 meters or 33 feet across, which is definitely bigger than the previous visitors like 2020 CV3 or 2006 RH120. Still, it's tiny compared to our permanent moon, which clocks in at a massive 3,474 kilometers across. Oh, and fun fact, Australia is actually wider than the moon at almost 4,000 kilometers across at its widest point. What's interesting is that 2024 PT5 won't complete a full orbit around Earth during its visit. Instead, it's on what scientists call a temporary captured flyby. It's here from September 29th, today, to November 25th in 2024, so just under 57 days before the sun's gravity pulls it back out on its journey around the sun. Now, you might be wondering, how confident are scientists about this mini moon's path? Well, this mini moon result comes from this paper by astronomers Carlos and Raul de la Fuente Marcos. In their investigation, they considered a wide range of potential trajectories using what they call control orbits. These orbits account for different uncertainties in the asteroid's initial observations. And all of the models, even with small variations, confirm that 2024 PT5 is set to be a mini moon of Earth for about 57 days. In their investigation, they also compared 2024 PT5 to another mini moon, 2022 NX1, which followed a very similar path. And the predictions for that object were spot on. So the De La Fuente Marcos research team are confident that they've got 2024 PT5's short-term trajectory nailed down. However, predicting its future visits is a bit trickier. There are some uncertainties as we look further into the future, like its expected return in 2055, because as it drifts through space, close encounters with Earth or the moon could nudge it off course slightly. Still, for now, we can be pretty sure that 2024 PT5 will be sticking around for a few weeks of mini moon fun. Unfortunately, if you're hoping to catch a glimpse of this mini moon, it won't be visible to the naked eye. Not even most backyard telescopes will be able to see it because of just how small and faint it is. You're gonna need some serious gear, like a telescope at least 30 inches wide, paired with a sensor detector to see it. Even though this might be the first time you've heard of Earth having a mini moon, it turns out that this may not be as rare of an event as you'd suspect. So, how often does Earth pick up these temporary moons? Well, it turns out they're relatively frequent visitors, at least when it comes to the short stay ones. For mini moons like 2024 PT5, which only stick around for a few weeks or months, scientists estimate these events happen several times per decade. So while they're not as regular as, say, your morning coffee, they do happen often enough that we could see a few more in the near future. Now, when it comes to longer mini-moon events, like those lasting a year or more, things get a bit rarer. These are estimated to occur every 10 to 20 years instead. For example, one of the longest recorded mini-moon events was 2006 RH120, which orbited Earth for 13 months between 2006 and 2007. So this means we might have more mini-moons floating around than we realize. Some may simply fly under the radar because of our current detection limitations. But as technology improves and scientists continue studying these fascinating space rocks, our understanding of how often they show up will only get better. So while mini moons may seem like rare events, they're more like regular visitors that we're just beginning to fully notice. So as of today, Earth really does have a second moon. Well, sort of. Our mini moon, 2024 PT5, may not be the grand glowing orb that we're all used to, but it's very real and it'll be hanging out with us until November 25th. While it's easy to get caught up in the excitement or skepticism that comes with seeing headlines about Earth gaining another moon, this mini moon is no over-sensationalized story. It is a tiny asteroid temporarily captured by our planet's gravity, and even though you probably won't spot it in the night sky, its presence is still a reminder of how dynamic and unpredictable our corner of the universe can be. So while our new moon might not make the kind of splash you'd expect, I think it's pretty neat that for the next 57 days, Earth has a special guest, and we'll get to see it again in January 2025. So stay curious and keep looking up.
Action.
Oh. That's very funny. I was literally like this when you said action. You suck. Calling action while not looking as well is just a piece of the cake. Okay, I'm about to go.
Action. Thank you. You two get more of a British accent now, folks.
Forgot that I was going to get
things get a bit rarer.
Things get a bit rarer.
Things get a bit rarer.
Rarer.
May not be as rare as you would expect.